بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. إخواني في الله، كيف أنت والتزامك بكتاب الله؟ عقدنا عقدا، تذكرون؟ How you all doing with your commitment with the book of Allah? Remember we made a commitment. ما نترك لكم. I'm not going to leave you alone about that. Everybody has a commitment to the book of Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are you? What's your commitment? Huwa li maslahati nafsik. It's for you. It's for your benefit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala anzala lana kitaba wa arsala lana nabiyya. Allah revealed to us his book and sent to us his messenger. Mada naf'al bihima? What are we going to do with it? Na'am. من سيلتزم بكتاب الله يقرأه ويحفظه ويدرسه؟ من يتطوع لنا؟ من يرفع يده؟ من يلتزم؟ Who's gonna volunteer and commit himself to the book of Allah؟ لما كنا في دمشق كان الشيخ يحيى حفظه الله يقول كلمة كنت أستعظمه. Sheikh Yahya used to say something. Every now and then I used to say how enormous that is. كان يقول وحبت نفسي لله وحبت لساني لله. I gave myself up for Allah. I used to be like, wow, how could somebody say that? أنا وحبت لساني for Allah. وحبت نفسي لله. I gave myself up from Allah. I have nothing to do with this دنيا. كنت أستعظمه. يعني كان عظيم عندي. نعم هذا عظيم يا إخوان. من خلاص تخلص من الدنيا من ما يبالي يأتي الحاصل ببص يكفي لا شك ربك كريم. Who's like whatever comes from the dunya comes. I'm with Allah. Allah is gonna take care of me. Allah يطعم. You see these stray dogs in the street. The stray dogs eat well. They're fat. Stray dogs. والكفرة Sakara, how Allah is Sukara, these people are drunk. Allah, you tell them Allah feeds and gives them drink. I'm the mu'min. If you embark upon Allah, na'am, la yahammuk. Na'am. Can you yafkur an Imam Shukani fi durusina? An hu yaqul talibu ilm yamut min jur? Mustahil. Mustahil. Talibu ilm is going to die from hunger? It's impossible. It's impossible. على ما ذكروا ما أدري هل حفظته تماما. I don't know if I memorized it exactly. ولكن من يهب نفسه لله. Who's going to give themselves up from Allah? Whatever comes, comes. كم من طالب الدنيا ما يحصله. How many people chasing for الدنيا? They don't get it. سمعت كلمة اليوم. Yeah, I'm sorry. سمعت كلمة مضيع الشريم مدور الإبرة. عندكم كلمة مثل هذا يا عين عبد الرحمن يا عبد الرحمن هذا عندكم هكذا يا بعداني مضيع شريم مدور إبر نعم الشريم is this big knife it turns like this and they use it to cut you know, the bottom of the corn and it's a big knife it's a saw but it's a curved thing. Some people, they lose this shirim while they're looking for a needle. You know what I'm saying? They're trying to get something trivial and they lose something major. هذا هو الشاهد. نعم. They lose their big sword looking for a needle. نحن ندور الدنيا ضيع الدين. We're looking for dunya and we lose the deen. نعم. ما شاء الله ما شاء الله بارك الله فيكم يا إخواني في الله القرآن لا يطالب منا سبع ساعات ولا خمسة ولا ثلاثة The book of Allah doesn't request from us 5 hours a day, 7 hours a day, not 3 hours a day. 15 هناك 20 هناك 15 minutes this time and 20 minutes, 20 15 minutes, 15 minutes there, but every day, every day. لأن نفوسنا تباشرها وتعارضها أمور. Our souls, when we go out on the street, phew, we're running into like accidents. You know, you have like a car accident. We have nufus accidents, like clash. Like your heart, if it was your car has a fender bender, it has a bumper. It's not like you're on a motorcycle. You got doors, you got an engine, you got the back. When somebody hits you, they just hit your back of the car, but you're protected, you know? I'm a nefsuk. Your eyes, bam, right in your eyes, boom. Your ears, man, you have an accident. It's like a car accident, you know? For nahtaj, you need what is going to purify your soul from that. Rectify it. Rectify it. بكتاب الله. فما معنى هذا الأثر؟ ومن القائل؟ القرآن مأدبة الله، فمن دخل فهو آمن. من القائل يا أبا إدريس؟ القرآن مأدبة الله، فمن دخل فهو آمن. من القائل عندك يا إبراهيم؟ يا باب الرحمن، ما شاء الله من كلمة، عجبني هذه الكلمة. هو كلام ليس من كلام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا ها هنا من معنا، من كان حاضرا؟ عندك أم صالح؟ عندك مسجل؟ عندك يا عبد الصبور؟ القرآن مأدبة الله، من دخل فهو آمن. هذا قال عبد الله بن مسعود. This is the statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. ما معنى مأدوبة؟ ماذا قلنا؟ ما هي مأدوبة؟ مأدوبة يا أبا عبد الرحمن. مأدوبة. نعم، مائدة. طعام. مأدبة is طعام الله الرجل يصنعه للضيوف. It's طعام that somebody prepares for guests. وأحسن الطعام الذي يصنعه الرجل للضيوف لأنه يبالغ في طيبه ويشكل أنواعه. The best food is the food that somebody prepares for guests because he goes out his way to make it good. And he has a variety of things on there. فابن مسعود شبه القرآن بمأدبة, a meal, full course meal. Ibn Mas'ud made a resemblance between food and the Quran. لأن القرآن قوت القلوب كأن الطعام قوت الأجسام. انتهينا. The resemblance is, the similitude is that the Quran is the food and nutrition of the heart, like the food is the nutrition of the body. Okay? فقال من دخل فهو آمن. Whoever takes this مأدوبة and enters it, he's the one who's safe. ما معنى he's safe? And قلبه, his heart is safe. طيب, اسمع. الطعام الذي نأكل, the food that we eat, and it's vitamin C, vitamin D, vitamin K, the three B's, you know with me? The three B's, you know, it's vitamin D, you need vitamin A, right? It has iron, has minerals also. Na'am. Tell you, but how do you feed the jism? It benefits your body. Like vitamin K is like to help your blood from clotting, it helps your blood clot. Like if you get a cut, the blood doesn't just flow, the blood stops. That's absolute vitamin K. Vitamin D is for your bones, right? Vitamin C is for this. Vitamin C helps your immune system. You have iron, you have zinc, you have magnesium, you have all kinds of potassium, all kinds of things of your body. Your heart needs these kind of vitamins and minerals. It's in the book of Allah. فَإِذَا أَصَابَكَ شَيْءٍ. Some people, if something becomes to them and they're hazinin, يَبْقَى حَزِينٍ سَنِينٍ. They remain in grief for years. Maybe that child passed away or they lost their business, then for the rest of their life, hazin. والثاني ثم يفحص له الدلب قدر ما جاء على إلا نعم. And somebody he might get some money and he's like alhamdulillah I got this money. والثاني متكبر كأنه يعني ملك الدنيا كلها كأنه رئيس الدنيا like he own the world now. He's got a little bit of dunya. He's متكبر. You don't know that. يعني he has سوء التغذية just like your body can have malnutrition. What about your heart? It could be malnourished. طيب كما قال عبد الله مالك بن دينار يا أهل القرآن ما زرأ القرآن في قلوبكم فإن القرآن ربيع القلوب. What did the Quran sprout in your heart? What did the Quran plant and sprout in your heart? What did it produce in your heart? Verily the Quran is ربيع القلوب. It's the spring. It's the water that goes through the heart and it nourishes it. نعم. So our heart needs like you need things for your iron and for your zinc and for your bones and for your what you need that for our heart so that when things come to us sadness grief smile. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam يقول لا يصيب المسلم من وصب ولا نصب ولا سقم ولا حزن ولا هم يهمه إلا كفر الله بها من خطايا. هذه المول الذي يصيبه أن سعيده ليس فيها عيب ولا ذنب وهي مصائب. ما بالك المعاصي مثل الحسد والكبر والبخل والجبن. هذه ما في عيب يا أبا إدريس المائي. طيب. The Prophet said لا يصيب المسلم من وصب هو مرض. نعم. والنصب is difficulty. والسقم is illness. نعم. وحزن is grief. وهم is worry. These things that afflict your nafs. حزن it doesn't touch your bones. You understand what I'm saying? And pain. This pain hits your heart. نعم. Now when these things hit your heart, what do you have to defend? What do you have? Get some vitamin K. Get some zinc. Does vitamin C help you when you're in depression? MashaAllah, I know you eat that meat every day and you take your vitamins, you take your iron and your zinc and your three B's. But then when you get some money, you become arrogant. It's going to help you to be patient. These things that I mentioned in this hadith, none of them are sin. There's no shame. It just happens to mankind. Hal hazin nabiyyuna Muhammad? Naam. Hal baka nabiyyuna Muhammad? Did he get, hal ghadib? Did he get upset? Naam. These things happen, but it just happens. يأتي مصيبة, a catastrophe comes and hits him. So the Prophet said, Al-Quran ma'dubatullah, man dakhal fahuwa amin. Like whoever takes from the ma'duba, he's safe. You know, when the calamity hits him, he has a seatbelt on. He has spiritual seatbelt on. Bam, he can take the collision. He can handle it. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى قال, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ النقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين ما معنى وش هذا اللام ولنبلونكم وش هذا اللام ما هذا اللام قسم الله saying والله I'm going to test you Allah I swear he's going to test us with fear and hunger والله I'm going to test you You have to have your seatbelt on. You have to have some safety. والقرآن مأدبة الله. It's a full course meal, but spiritual meal. To give you all the nutrients you need to deal with the life of this world. Some people, man, one catastrophe destroyed their whole life. Y'all just support you with me? Either good or bad. One person, people might get good and he lost his mind. And lost his mind. I'm in a good camp. And some people, bad comes in. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً We touch you with evil and good. Allah touches us with both. بَارَكُلَّهُ فِيكُمْ لَا بُدْ أَن نَأْخُذْ مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ وَنَقْرَأَهُ لَكَيْ نَتَحَمَّلْ مَا يُصِيبُنَا so we can handle that which afflicts us from the life of this world. فَمَنْ دَخَلْ فَهُوَ آمِنْ. He's safe. آمِنْ means he's safe. You take from مَأْدُوبَ تُلَّهُ مَا يَهَمُّكْ. مَا يَهَمُّكْ. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. Allah doesn't give us all more than he can bear. نعم. لكن بعض الناس ييأس. بعض الناس, they just despair. Forget, I can't do it. لا أقدر. لا أصبر. نعم. بارك الله فيكم يا إخوة. فلنلتزم بكتاب الله. ونفوسنا نشتاق. Our souls love the book of law. It needs it. It's nourishment for it. نعم. It's nourishment. فالذي أريد أقول يفوتنا بعض البركات. Some things they pass us by. في هذه الآية أقرأه الآن شيء عجيب الذي نغفل عنه. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول وكذلك أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا وصرفنا فيه من الوعيد لعلهم يتقون أو يحدث لهم ذكرى. هذا أو هذا. وكذلك أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا. Like that we sent it down a Arabic recitation. وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْوَئِيدِ. صَرَّفَ تَنَوَّعَ فِيهِ الْوَئِيدِ. التخويفات متنوعة. دعنا والنعم. دعنا والبشرى. وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْوَئِيدِ. التخويفات متنوعة متشكلة. هذا الذي يفيدنا. هذا عظيم يا أبا مالك أتماعي. لا إله إلا الله. ما درينا ما عرفنا ما في هذا الكتاب. نعم. Allah says وصرفنا. We made different in it. We made all different kinds of وعيد. Different kinds of threats. Different things that scare you and strike fear in it. We make all different kinds. Really? If you know the different kinds of threats in the book of Allah, yeah, explain this to me because I'm not even benefiting. قال لعلهم يتقون. So that perhaps they might have taqwa, they might fear Allah. Or يحدث لهم ذكرى. It will remind, it will renew for them the ذكر. Even some people don't have taqwa, or some people have it, but it'll wake them up. وصرفنا فيه من الوئيد. Like we made different kinds of threats and fears, different kinds. لأن قلوبنا ما تكفي واحدة. No, like we need more than one kind. والله سبحانه وتعالى يذكر يقول وما نرسل بالآيات إلا تخويفا. We don't send any signs except تخويفا. تعرف من تخويف؟ خوفا. To make somebody afraid. والتخويف is the مصدر. Like علم تعليم درس تدريس. خوف تخويف. Allah says ما نرسل بالآيات إلا تخويفا. We don't send any ayats except تخويفا to cause fear in the people. Allah يريد يخوفنا. Like هل نستفيد؟ Do we benefit? والله سبحانه وتعالى يقول ونخوفهم فما يزيدهم إلا طغيان كبير. And we strike fear in them, it only increases them in arrogance and transgression. ربنا يريد أن يخوفنا. يريد أن يخوفنا. He wants to strike fear in us. لأن هذا الذي يجرنا عن المعاصي. That's what pulls us back from المعاصي. That's what's going to pull us back. Nah. وَبُشْرَاهُ. His good news is going to push us up to Jannah. Nah. But we need that. Nah. But in this ayat, Allah says, وَصَرَّفْنَا فِيهِ مِنَ. We made all different kinds of threats. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول في سورة الزمر وهو واصفا أهوال في نار جهنم. He's describing the affairs in the hellfire. يعني ما كنا نعرف إيش في نار جهنم. No, we wouldn't know. قبل هذا يا إخواني في الله جاء من حديث أبي هريرة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الله تعالى. Allah said أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. I have prepared in Jannah for my righteous servants that which no eye has ever seen it, no ear has ever heard it, no heart has ever pondered upon it, and never even thought about it. It's just too extreme. يعني يريد أن يكرمهم. He wants to honor them and reward them. فإذا فهمنا هذا, if we understand that, ما بالنا بأناس الله يريد أن يهينهم ويعذبهم. If we understand that, what about some people Allah wants to punish them and humiliate them? هل يكون عذاب ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. Is it going to be a punishment no eye has ever seen? No ear has ever heard the likes of this. It's punishment. And no man ever even thought about it. So ننظر إلى هذا الوعيد. الله شكل الوعيد. وصرفنا فيه من الوعيد. It's different kinds of وعيد. وعيد. طيب. يا إخوان أنا ما أريد أتكلم على غير مفهوم. I don't want to talk and nobody understands what I'm saying. نعم. فالمرفق بين الوعد والوعيد. I'll start right there. What's the difference between a وعد and وعيد? عندك عبد الصبور. What's a وعد? وعد الله. ما معنى وعد? وعد. You know this word. وعد. عندك يا إبراهيم. وعد الله وعد. You have وعد, you have وعيد. لا يخلف الله وعده. عندك يا إبراهيم. عندك يا إبراهيم. No, it's a promise. You know this word, وعد, it's the promise. So ما معنى وعيد? Any وعد is in good, وعيد is bad. Like if I promise you something good, that's a promise. If I promise you something bad, I'm going to do this, that's a وعيد, something bad. That's all a promise. وإخلاف الوعد هذا ضم وعين. ولكن إخلاف الوعيد رحمة, ما فيها شيء. To break your promise, that's bad, that's low. But to break your threat is mercy. There's nothing wrong with breaking your threat. ما فيها شيء. ما فيها شيء. طيب. فالله صرفنا صرف في الوعيد. إن وعيد الله صرف. He made different kinds of وعيد. Different kinds of threats. نعم. He's going to do this. We're going to do that. We're going to do this. We're going to do that. الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال. في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم. نحن يا إخواني في الله هذا الوعيد على يعيدنا. He's threatening us with this, ولكن ما فهمناه حتى نقعد. Allah's threatening us with these things and help us, but we don't even know what it is, so we'll be afraid. وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال. The people of the in Helfa fi samum. Ma ma'na samum. Allah says the people in Helfa fi samum. Wa hamim wa dhillin min yahmum. La barid wa la kareem. Ma ma'na samum? Helfa fa la ma huwa nar. Na'am. Ahsan, barakallah fiqh. Arrih, it's just the wind, the hot wind that's coming from the fire. It's like, what's the, if you see smoke, that's the deal that there's what? That there's fire. And you feel the wind coming, like you feel wind hot, air coming, you see smoke, like, there must be a fire back over there. Must be a fire. You have this strong hot wind coming on you. Fi samum. Wa hamim, ma mana hamim? Hot water. But then hot water and hot wind. They even see the fire. وَظِلٍ مِنْ يَحْمُومٍ. ما معنى يَحْمُومٍ? ظِل is shade. not the shade of walls or the shade of trees, shade of smoke. That, if there's smoke, there must be a fire back there. They're in the shade of smoke. This is a wa'id from Allah, but we need to understand it. That's the key. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul lahum min fawqihim dhulalun min an-nar wa min tahtihim dhulal, yani ashkal wa anwa', they have shades, dhulal min an-nar, shade. Look, this is just the shade of the fire. Dhul is different kinds of shades. The shade of it is different. About having loud chains, clamps, hot water, fire, all kinds of stuff. لَهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ ظُلَلٌ مِنَ النَّارِ وَمِنْ تَحْتِهِمْ and under them, ظُلَلٌ. Now, we're trying to use our imagination to imagine it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ يُخَوِّفُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عِبَادَةً يَا عِبَادِ فَاتَّقُونِي. عش من رحمة يا إخوان ماذا نحتاج بعد هذا دلائل. Allah said ذلك is اسم إشارة. Allah is pointing at that picture that he just painted. قال ذلك يخوف الله به عبادة. Allah strikes fear with this picture in his servants. All my servants fear me. He's done the job. Allah took care of me. He explained everything. Explain what's in the hellfire. He told us the purpose of why he explains it so we can fear him. And he says fear me. Muslim. فهذه معنى القرآن مأدبة الله. Like if it was a meal, نعم, you would have your potatoes, you have your starch, your نشويات. وعندك اللحم, you have your starch, you have your lamb, you have your bread, you have your vegetables, you have your raw salad. نعم. لأن كل هذا الذي يفيد الجسم. نعم أنتم معي يا إخوان. All those things benefit your body. Tell your heart needs a ma'duba also. It needs different kinds of things in it. وكله في كتاب الله. ففي الأخير في آية انظر إلى هذا العذاب من الله. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى إذ الأغلال في أعناقهم والسلاسل يسحبون في الحميم ثم في النار يسجرون ثم قيل لهم أينما كنتم تشركون. يعني بعد هذا كلها توبيخ, يعني ما كفتم النار؟ لا لا نعم لا إله إلا الله. هل سمعنا عذابا أو رأينا عذابا مثل هذا؟ إذ الأغلال, ما معنى أغلال؟ إذ الأغلال في أعناقهم, ما معنى غل؟ ما معنى أغلال؟ أغلال is a clamp that goes on the hands. ولكن الله said الأغلال في أعناقهم, their أغلال, the clamps on the hands, is going to be on their necks. When they're going to have the clamps on their hands, then Allah is going to clamp their hands to their necks. إهانة, humiliated. إذ الأغلال في أعناقهم والسلاسل, they have chains on it. يسحبون, they're going to be dragged like that. Have you ever seen anybody dragged like that? Have you ever seen anybody dragged? SubhanAllah, I mean. If like a prisoner or a murderer or a rapist got dragged, people go, no, he has rights. they would scream and yell. No? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذِ الْأَغْلَالِ, the clamps on their hands, فِي أَعْنَاقِهِمْ, the clamps on their hands are going to be on their necks that day. Their hands are going to be tied to the necks. وَالسَّلَاسِ is going to have chains. يُسْحَبُونَ, they're going to be dragged. فِي الْحَمِيمِ, in hot water. كَمْ مَا مَأْنَا ثُمَّ فِي النَّارِ, after they're in the hot water, مَا مَأْنَا ثُمَّ, مَا مَأْنَا ثُمَّ. لكن ماذا فرق بين ثم والفاء؟ مثلا أقول جاء محمد وزيد, جاء محمد فزيد, جاء محمد ثم زيد. أقول ذهبت وأكلت، ذهبت فأكلت، ذهبت ثم أكلت. أنتم إيه يا أبا عبد الرحمن؟ ذهبت وأكلت. What does that mean? ذهبت وأكلت. Wow does not indicate what you did first. You just did that and that. There is no ترتيب in a wow. There's no sequence. I ate, I went and I ate. We don't know what you did first. And ذهبت وأكلت. ذهبت فأكلت. فهذا يدل على ترتيب يعني قريب. ترتيب بلا مهلة. بلا مهلة. That I ate and then immediately afterwards I went and immediately afterwards I ate. Immediately. فا is ترتيب بلا مهلة. It's a sequence out, no waiting period. أما ذهبت ثم أكلت. That's ترتيب مع مهلة. نعم. But I went, but that doesn't mean I ate immediately after. That's what I'm saying. It wasn't immediately after. So what do we understand? يسحبون في النار في الحميم ثم في النار. What does that mean, ثم في النار? That they're in hot water a long time. هذا معنى ثم. That's what it means. That they're going to be in there a long time, years. They just, you think, just dipped in the water and come out? No. ثم في النار. That they're going to be in the water a long time. هذه اللغة العربية يا إخوان. That's what Arabic conveys. نعم. فالله سبحانه وتعالى يقول يسحبون في الحميم. They're going to be dragged in water. ثم في النار يسجرون. ثم in the fire they're going to be burnt. ثم. ما معنى ثم? They're going to be there a long time. After all of that. After all of that. ثم قيل لهم. That's going to be said to them. Where's the God you was worshiping? Man, after all that, I have to get like censor and blame? Yeah, subhanAllah. فهذا معنى قوله تعالى الذي قرأنا وسننتهي بهذا. هذا معنى قوله وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال. The people of the left hand, what is the people of the left? في سموم, in wind, وحميم, in hot water, وظل من يحبون. And in shade of smoke, لا بارد ولا كريم ولا كرام ولا شيء. Nothing is cold. There's nothing good. No honor. Nothing. Nothing for you. لا كريم بمعنى there is not كريم بمعنى خير. There is nothing good for you. Nothing. I mean, after going through all that hellfire and getting burnt, then after all that, you have ثم قيل لهم أين ما كنتم تشركون. No break. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول in Surah Al-Hajj or Surah Al-Sajda كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها أعيدوا فيها وقيل لهم ذوقوا عذاب الحريق. على مجرد إرادة ليس محاولة ليس حركة ليس حركة. كلما أرادوا, every time they want to get out, not they try to get out, just if they just think about it, they dip back down in the fire. لا بارد ولا كريم. There's nothing cold. There's no honor for them. No honor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كلما أرادوا أن يخرجوا منها. Every time they want to get out, they put back down. وَإِيدُوا فِيهَا وَقِيلَ. It's going to be said to them, ذُوقُوا عَذَابَ الْحَرِيقِ. Taste the fire. Every time they want to go out, they put out taste the fire. Taste the fire. Just so that they just give up. Well, they won't just try no more. هل وصف لنا عذاب مثل هذا من قبل؟ فهذا معنى قوله تعالى وصرفنا فيه من الوعيد. Allah put all kinds of things to strike fear in it. He explained how he sent ريح. He sent things. He destroyed mountains. He destroyed people. He did that. فهذا معنى قول ابن مسعود القرآن مأدوبة الله فمن دخل فهو آمن. Whoever takes from this مأدوبة, which is food that's prepared, it's been prepared. It has everything you need in it, for nutrients, and comfort, taste, everything. Whoever takes part of this, then he's the one who saves. هذا درسنا الليلة. كان المفروض نأخذ درس من عمدة الأحكام، ولكن هذه الكلمات سبقت. These statements preceded. نسأل الله يجعل فيها بركة، ونسأل الله to put بركة and good in it. This is sufficient for the day. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب.